This is a shocker of video of a video. You know how in the like the EU they hold an emergency meeting, there's a crisis, they hold an emergency meeting. Well, we're holding this emergency meeting here on this video. I have had the strongest constellation of indications ever, and I'm reeling from it. I actually got physically ill. I guess I went into some kind of shock. I should have identified it as wow. I'm trying to. And so if we can get through this straight away, and I won't do it too severely because it may be shocking, just as suddenly, one thing after the other, boom. As I said, this week was the most important week in history. We top it off tomorrow, Monday night, with the fourth blood moon of the tetrad. And son of a gun, it has been the most consequential week in history, really. And in hindsight, looking back at what happened, I realize now these indications have been given to me previously in years past. It says, look for these signs. When you see these signs, know that that is the time. And these signs have now happened. So this is why the alarm bells are ringing here. So let us start. We know this last week had to do with the Sustainable Development Goal Summit in the United Nations, and the Pope and the President, the purpose of the Pope coming up here ultimately was to address the UN, and then the President of the United States addressed the UN, I think this morning, very forcefully, and the purpose is to push this agenda through. Now, the Sustainable Development Goal Summit is based on what's called Agenda 21. And Agenda 21 is a global blueprint for the 21st century. Agenda 21 stands for the 21st century. And it's something that was agreed upon back, I think, when was it? In the 90s? Or was it even earlier in that, 80s? Maybe it was in the 80s, right? It's been around for a while. And they've been having summits and conferences and all, through the years, refining. This summit here in New York was the final stamp of approval. And I just found out today that all 193 countries ratified it. So, and then there's a climate conference in Paris, which this summit in New York was designed to give tremendous push to the climate change conference in Paris. So this event in New York this last week was of ultimate significance for the world and for our future. And it came out of this Agenda 21, and you know where Agenda 21 was birthed. This is what shocked me when I found out about this. Because I had this dream years ago that showed me the real plot in this world. People call it a conspiracy. You can call it that for sure. And I saw how sophisticated it was, and I saw the whole thing, and I said, wow, how in the world can I explain this? And yet, I was told that this whole thing originated in Brazil. Okay, during this dream, it was crystal clear, it originated in Brazil. So I kept thinking, what is Brazil doing that is so important that it could cause change the world and bring the world into a very, very nasty, bad situation? This is what was in the dream. Terrible. Well, I just found out that Agenda 21, the first summit that this book, what the agenda was adopted, was in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. I believe that's Brazil, Rio. And that they've had a number of conferences after that, also in Brazil. So the initiative came out of Brazil, just like in my dream. It came out of Brazil. Now, all the member states were meeting there, so Brazil is not like the one that crafted all this, but it was located, came out of Brazil. That's what the dream was showing me. And now in reading the Sustainable Development Sustainable Development Goal Agenda, and actually going through all these articles, I said, wow. Holy cow, does the world really know what it's in for? And so the Holy Spirit has been right on the money. Okay, so this is one indication that this is what we are looking at. This is the trouble. This initiative, this agenda, the Agenda 21 is indeed the troublemaker for the world. And there's many facets to the trouble it's going to bring about. and that the Pope and the President were the two main forces that are pushing this in the world, reassuring the rest of the world that they are all for it. So that means the rest of the world goes in for it too. It's a very important meeting here in New York the last several 3 days with the Russian Putin and the Chinese premier, or however they call it, actually coming to the United States. This is almost unprecedented, the two of them both here in the United Nations. This was the big one. Now, it gets much deeper than that. Much deeper than that, as far as the tipping point. We've reached the tipping point here. And I'm not sure what's going to happen exactly, but it is going to happen soon. Okay. In the autumn of this year, this is what I've been told, the autumn of 2015. And so, here's something else that happened, which is just astonishing. Back in 2003, I was in the desert. I was visiting the relatives in the desert, and we were at this beautiful, beautiful location, just like paradise, under the palm trees and beautiful pools and ponds, and we're just enjoying it so much. One of the best days of my life. And we left there driving. I was driving, and suddenly we came across this scene, and the road was blocked, and there's all these cars stopping, people out wandering around. I said, "Uh-oh, this doesn't look good." And I got out, and there had been an accident. And long story short, nobody had thought to call 911. I actually called 911 and got the paramedics out there, but the road was blocked. And we had to go back up the road, back to this paradise-like place, and we just stayed there for another hour or two, just eating food and relaxing and trying to calm down, because I was just distraught about what I had experienced there. Now, what I experienced there was these four young men in a Volkswagen Beetle bug, and they had flipped the bug, and they'd all been thrown out of the bug, and so there's this terrible problem around the situation with Volkswagen, a terrible problem involving Volkswagen, okay? And one of the guys was all tattooed. He looked like he was very much sort of a drug culture type of person. There's four young white men, actually, white males. One, like in their late teens, early 20s. And he was unconscious, bleeding. He looked like he was at the verge of death. He was still alive, but I don't know if he survived or not. He was on the road there, terrible. There was another one who looked very thuggish kind of guy. And he was in severe shock. He may have had inner hemorrhaging in his brain, but he was standing up, and he was just moaning, and he was like, got just severe trouble. But he couldn't really talk. And the other two seemed to be sort of upper middle class youth, well bred, well brought up. But they realized they had done something terrible, and they were in a terrible situation. They were scraped up a little bit, but they were not as harmed. They were not harmed so badly, but they were traumatized, severely traumatized. But they were able to talk. I was able to talk to them, and they told me what happened. And there was this terrible problem with the Volkswagen. They went around a turn too fast, apparently. So I came away with this. The impression I had was very strong that this was something I was being shown to shock me out of fixation, to realize this is showing me what is to come in the world, and when you will know when it is to happen by what you're seeing here. And so I took away from that experience. I never forgot it. I was very traumatic. I realized that to look for certain signs to know what's going to happen. Now, I take it that there's something, that the quarter of the world is going to take the path of death, something like that. Very dark path. A quarter is going to be involved in some brutal situation, and then the other half is going to be appalled, shocked and appalled what comes upon this world. That they realize, oh, we made a big mistake hooking up with these people. Why did we even have them, why did we go along with this misadventure? It was a bad misadventure. I realized that it has something to do with that, and the timing of it had something to do with what's called the turnover, something with Volkswagen, some terrible situation with Volkswagen. Well, I haven't been watching the news, as I said, starting in the 29th of August. So I don't know what's going on. Now, I I looked up something about the UN sustainable climate thing, because this is very important. I was researching and I came across comments on this on the Guardian website, that they tend to lay things out pretty clearly. And someone said, hey, you know, yeah, environment, you know, is first thing we got to do is we got to get rid of the Volkswagen defeat device. And I said, Volkswagen defeat device? What the heck is that? But the Holy Spirit got my attention so severely, I was just like, I said, I have to find out what this means. What does this mean? This is very, very important. I said, this is odd. Why is this important? But I felt driven to find out. So I Googled in Volkswagen defeat device, and this is what has really blown my mind. I've been actually ill since I found out, but my stomach has been queasy, because this is, if you may not know about it, I mean, if those who like don't watch the news, I didn't know anything about it, but this happened in this last week too. The Holy Spirit told me this week in September is the biggest week in history, and it has happened. Volkswagen, which for me, if you ask me the greatest companies in the world, I'd name them as one of them for sure. Because we grew up, growing up in the 60s and the 70s, I mean, Volkswagen was they had the greatest reputation of integrity and honesty. They were in for the environment. I mean, everything. They were just, the best company ever. And most people, a lot of people in their lives have driven a Volkswagen. I certainly have, and most of my relatives and friends have driven Volkswagens. And what it is the worst scandal I've ever come across, worst corporate scandal I've ever come across in my life. And I'm just speechless. I'm speechless. Volkswagen basically put on this massive marketing campaign, ostensibly because they wanted to be the number one car manufacturer in the world to beat Toyota. And apparently they've done that right now. And it was around a new diesel engine that they had developed that was supposed to be this super engine that's going to help solve environmental problems around the world. I mean, this is just the greatest thing that's ever happened to automobiles, called the TDI, turbo direct injection or something. And I remember that they were marketing that in the United States so heavily that I became aware of it. I said, what the heck is going on? Volkswagen seems to have, developed and, has redesigned the wheel or something. This is big. And they market like this is really world-changing, this new engine we've got, because it has ultra-low emissions and fabulous gas mileage and performance. It's like the engine from heaven. And so they put on this huge blitzkrieg of advertising. I was taken in by it. I said, wow, great job, Volkswagen. I mean, you did it again, Started out with the Beetle, and now you're going to take the world by storm again by inventing something so fabulous like this. So to my absolute shock and dismay, it turns out this whole thing was a hoax, a fraud on the part of Volkswagen AG Automotive Group. And the emissions that they claimed and that they were getting in smog tests here in the United States were being tricked, defeated by sophisticated software in the car that was able to sense testing conditions when you're on just a static, they put you on these rollers and they're able to sense when the car was getting tested for emissions. And they were able to shut down certain areas of the car, so it went into low performance mode so that the emissions would come out low. And then once the car got out of the test, the software would shift it back, the engine, so it was in full performance mode. And this full performance mode puts out 40 times the nitrous oxide, whatever the one of the pollutants, 40 times the allowable amount. And the engine is a complete fraud. It's very polluting. And they sold 11 million of these engines worldwide, 450,000 in the United States. And this is just, well, it's the most colossal fraud I've ever come across in court. And I'm just shocked that Volkswagen would do this. I can't comprehend how Volkswagen could do this. I just can't comprehend it. I mean, what are they thinking? I mean, just idiocy. They thought they wouldn't be caught. I mean, what in the world were they thinking? Well, who was involved? Who did this? Who was involved? I can't believe that the higher management would go along with this. I just, it's astonishing what they did. Well, they're in huge, huge trouble. Volkswagen is in massive, this is probably the worst trouble any corporation's ever been in. I mean, you talk about lawsuits, you talk about recall. They got, what are they gonna do? Have to give people new cars? Or I mean, they're recalling all cars in the United States with TDI engines. The people, what are you gonna do? Lose my card on my car? What are you gonna do? You give me a new car? I'm gonna have to rental for a long time. They're gonna have to do some kit to fix this. But it's a nightmare. The legal implications of this and the fines. I mean, it's just going to devastate Volkswagen. And that accident I came was a devastating situation involving a Volkswagen, and I was told to look for some devastating situation involving Volkswagen. And you would know that the time is now for the troubles here in this world. So when I came across this, I like I said, I got ill. I had a sick stomach. I went into some sort of shock, because this is the sign that I was told to look for, along with all the other signs. They're just a massive constellation. Agenda 21 starting, in Rio, Brazil, now being pushed in, now being ratified with all countries in the world, with extreme strong push from all countries, basically. Even China's involved. They're all involved with this. This is the global agenda, the New World Order agenda, New World Agenda Order. And it has now reached the tipping point where the momentum now is theirs. And I laid out another video previously about some of these various articles that make it very clear of the kind of totalitarian spy data collection system that they intend to utilize in this. And just think of the amount of change that's happened in the last 15 years. Imagine that, times what? Times 20, 100, I don't know, in the next 15 years. We won't be able to recognize the world at all. Actually. Yeah, and so, yeah, this is all coming right then. The blood moon just happens to come right after this summit. I mean, this is extraordinary. This is extraordinary. This is the most important tipping point in world history. And they said this four tetrad blood moons would usher in some massive change in the world. It actually has happened. It has happened. So this, the Volkswagen scandal shows you what technology, that the mind of tech people, what they're capable of. I've always said they're deceivers. The mindset, the habits of these tech people, I find them to be appalling. The internet itself is appalling, and all the scams and weaselly stuff. It's just everything you run into is some scam, some trick. Yeah, it's free. Try it out. Oh. We didn't tell you that the fine, this and this and this and this and, it's just sickening. The sickening. These tech people are really sickening. And to think they could get away with it just shows you the audacity and arrogance of the tech people. To think that they could deceive the Environmental Protection Agency and everyone in the United States, and pollute this country, and think that we would all remain ignorant of it. This is audacity on a level that I'm just shocked by the audacity. I think most people find out about this are stunned by the sheer arrogance and audacity of this. It's very un-German-like, though, to do something like this. I mean, I don't know what the story is. They're usually very proud and want people to see, how good they've done, and to fall into deceit like this. It's extreme deceit. It shows a tremendous pride and arrogance in Germany right now. They wanted to be number one in the world, and they were willing to do this to get there. This is how they got there, by this massive deceit about their engines. So this is very, very chilling situation. And you say, what else are the tech people of the world capable of doing? Well, we already know they're spying on and collecting all our data. But the thing is, we expect that from the governments to be absolute slime. Okay, we don't expect it from Volkswagen. That's the last place I would expect it. The WikiLeaks and Snowden and all that with they've been like completely invading our privacy for a long time in the most heinous way. And they just kind of say, well, you know, it's necessary. We didn't really have to tell you sorry or something. This is just an appalling deceit by the technology people. Absolutely, completely unacceptable. They've been mining all our emails. I mean, can you, I mean, it's appalling beyond anything you can even describe. But you expect it from these slime balls, but did not expect it from Volkswagen. They have a very, very high brand reputation. And they're willing to destroy it by this, you know, to destroy their brand reputation. This is just crazy. So that was the sign that I was told to look for. And I was told it would, you know, 2015 would be the year. It's going to definitely happen. So we're right on track. I've been given indication something positive is going to happen for us. Very positive. Now, in this accident scenario, we went back to this paradise-like place. I said, well, you know, it's not so bad. We get to go back to this place. We're forced to go back to, like, paradise. So we may be forced to go back to paradise, so to speak, due to the appalling situations that come in the world. Now, there's one other thing I forgot to tell you, which just puts the icing on the cake. The tattooed, druggy-looking guy that looked like he may have been killed by this accident was just a severe brain damage or something. His name was Murph. They called him Murph. Hey, Murph, 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 Murph. The other guys were saying, Murph, wake up, come on, Murph, you can make it, you know, don't die on us, Murph. And so I said, you know, Murph, I got to look up that Murph, is very important. What does Murph mean? Well, the original definition, there's a lot of definition now, it pretty means much anything you want it to these days, but to Murph means, get this, this really shook me up. It basically means, here's an example of it, to think that you're getting an advantage by doing something, like they say, get in a grocery line, you think it's going to go faster. Okay, but it turns out the other one actually went faster and you ended up getting in the slow one. You say, I got Murphed. I got really, really, got really Murphed. You know, Murphy's Law. When it comes to Murphy's Law, I mean, you know, no matter, you know, I thought I was doing something to speed things up, but it turns out it slowed it down for me, messed it up for me. And the last video I did, I talked about how my real goal, the goal of those who are on the path of training to be spiritual teachers, is to try, do our best to help us, you know, avoid long-term fixation. Long-term fixation. That is what's so appalling for us. So what happens in the world is we think we see short-term gain, a way to go faster, and we avoid the patience that the spiritual path requires of continuity, fear, and the wow reaction. We keep pushing through it, pushing, think this is the fast way. We think this is the fast way, but it ends up fixating us long-term. Short-term speed burst, long-term fixation. This is the problem with Agenda 21. This is the real problem. People see short-term, we can get feel good, we have these goals, but they don't understand that they're really running right into extreme long-term fixation, believing they're a body, believing that there's such a thing as a world, there's a body. This is spiritual ignorance. So they're really going into long-term fixation. Others are getting severely murfed. And this Agenda 21 is murfing everybody. And the guy that was severely injured and maybe dying, his name was Murph. They called him Murph. How about that? In other words, this is the time we've gotten Murphed. The world is getting Murphed. We're told, go in this direction. Go in the direction of the 17 goals of the Sustainable Development Goal Agenda. Agenda 21 for the 21st century. Go in that direction. This is what is good for you. This is what is good. This is what we really want. This is what we all really want. This is good for you. This is great for you. This is going to make you feel good. No, it's not. It's going to result in long-term fixation, severe fixation on the belief in outcomes, which is totally false and ignorant. Spiritually ignorant position. So you're going into severe spiritual fixation and ignorance by following this Agenda 21 SDG, Sustainable Development Goals. We're getting Murphed. The world is getting Murphed. And this is what I was shown. So, this is just, this is almost knocking me out. That all of the signs I was given, suddenly you're realizing, we're here. We're here now. This is it. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Because that means good news is coming too. Very good news. Now this whole thing about paradise, I don't know. We have to go back to sidestep this murfing, because we don't want to be involved with this murfing. That'll end up fixating us, because we're being told that we're fast tracking towards some sort of righteousness, when in fact we're only going to be heavily investing in the belief in outcomes, which is to get fixated, because in reality there's no such thing as outcomes. There's no concretization. Anywhere. It doesn't exist. It's a false belief. It's arrogance to believe in this. So the whole planet is getting murfed. So somehow we're going to retreat back to some situation which is really, really beautiful and really, really nice, and sit out. We stay there until all the emergency crews have done everything, cleaned everything up, and that did their thing. Because, I feel I would be despondent seeing the world the way it's going and realizing that, my goal is to help free people, help them realize that they can get free from long-term fixation by spiritual practice, right? Spiritual practice. This is the truth. And to see a world not doing that, instead going all in and getting totally murfed by going all in on trying to gain some positive outcomes, it is debilitating to me, absolutely. And I don't have the long-term viewpoint of, how salvation works. I have a more, short-sighted vision of it, as you would expect here in this world. Whereas the big-term picture, they say, it's just a minor little blip in the screen. It's no big deal, and it all works out fine in the end, as Ramana Maharshi would say. Everything works out perfect in the end, don't worry. Yeah, right, of course. But when you're caught up in this, and there's more immediacy to it. So there's going to be something, something happening now that we decide, it's best that we really, sit this murfing out. We're not going to go along with that. How that will take place, I don't know. I don't know exactly, but we'll discover it soon. Soon, I would say. So, indeed, again, Holy Spirit, right on the money. Right on the money, to the exact week. Gave me the urgency, gave me the information, and I passed it along. It turns out hindsight to be exactly right. And this VW scandal broke during this last week. Very chilling thing to realize that the tech people just feel that they can have a right to use technology any way they, as long as they don't get caught, any way they want to. And they've been doing that. We've been discovering. When we catch them, we realize they've been doing this for a long time. They just feel that they can be sneaky about everything. And again, sophisticated, subtle sophistication with artificial intelligence makes people believe they can arrive at subtle outcomes, which will be winning for them. And these people, there's no question, this is their outlook. This is their outlook of the people who have the mindset of technology. They feel they can game the system, come out on top. They can, get great outcomes. So that the SDG, Agenda 21, has made it crystal clear that they've launched this technology initiative to collect data on everybody in the world, so that everybody can be measured about the progress can be measured. They've made it crystal clear that this is what they're going to do, which is what people have been warning about, right? So the warnings that have been coming have turned out to be mostly true. People saying that this new world order is bad business, bad situation. They're right. They're absolutely right. Now, they don't really know what to do about it. We're much more dialed in to that because we have, you know, we understand the spiritual context of why is it important that we safeguard our momentum that we have towards realization that there's no such thing as outcomes at all. There are no outcomes. And to believe in outcomes, even good ones, is to be sunk in extreme delusion, self-delusion, and the resulting continuity fear. So we do not want to get into the habit of falling into that trap. That is for sure. And now the networking, you know, there's all these, just listing all these celebrities to start helping them out with this, and all these, you know, they'll be, you know, urging all their followers in social media to, they're saying, choose one of these goals and make it your own. Is everybody supposed to choose a goal? So they're going to be marketing. I said, the Holy Spirit tipped me off, there's going to be the heaviest marketing campaign in history over the next 9 months, next 38 weeks or so. 40 weeks, that's probably about 9 months, 38 weeks. Human gestation period, pretty amazing. Right to June 21st, 2016, which the Holy Spirit also told me is pretty much a cutoff date. That this initiative will then be irreversible by that time. So he said the world's going to be irreversibly changed by that time. He told me that. And in 2014, late 2014, I believe, I was shown that, or maybe a little earlier than that, we would be going through this period where by the time we reach June 21st, 2016, the changes would be, the momentum and change in this world would be irreversible. Everybody would be caught up into it now. And you can see that this marketing campaign, they're going to roll out on every single level, and the president is absolutely committed to this. He made it very clear this is his number one priority now, the rest of the time he has in office, and he's going to take every measure possible he's absolutely committed to roll, getting everybody to go along with this in the United States and in the world. And you know how he works. He'll foment any sort of crisis to get his way. And so this is serious business. They mean business here. And he's going to write executive orders right and left. He's going to put in the bureaucrats that he wants who are all in on this, the judges, the bureaucrats, everything. He's already been doing that, appointed more judges than anyone in history, and they're because they're all in on this, actually. So the laws are going to become draconian. People are going to be forced, you know, forced into this legally in many, many different ways. And so this is a global commitment rollout to pressure all citizens and to herd him into this agenda, Agenda 21. And it's go time right now. Right now it's go time. The summit's over. And that means it's Holy Spirit time to show us an alternative to this. So we're in good shape. It's just a little shocking that they realize that it really is go time now. The Holy Spirit just showed me, this is the time I told you, you know, is go time. And so it will be. So the Holy Spirit will have an alternative to this. So we're waiting, eagerly waiting for that. So we're trying to get in a very positive mood to looking forward to that. Looking forward to that. Now, of course, because we believe in outcomes so much, to drop any belief in outcomes immediately is the continuity fear, dropping pretense, pretending they're outcomes. So for a while, it may seem like we're moving towards some outcome, but keep in mind, ultimately, what we're being moved towards is the recognition there's no such thing as outcomes at all. We're perfectly free. There's no such thing as being bound into some outcome. It doesn't exist. Every outcome is ours, you know. Every instant, we're completely free for any experience we want to. So there's no such thing as an outcome. It's not possible. So we're going to realization of no outcomes, but it may seem on the way like, well, we're getting some sort of positive experiencing going on, right? We might label it that way or see it that way for a while, which is fine. It's just fine. It's all about the continuity fear and how to move ourselves away from that gradually and effectively. So the Holy Spirit is going to have roll out its alternative to Agenda 21. And we will find out what it is very soon. Very, very soon. Maybe even tomorrow. Maybe even tomorrow. Or today, if you're viewing this the 28th, maybe even today, the 28th. Taping this in the evening, the 27th. So I feel very, very positive. I've been giving out the right information, by and large, and warning people in advance in a correct manner, and then pinpointing exact week when it's pivotal week, cutting back from the news, getting good habits going, so we can go into October lean and mean and have a full head of steam in October, believing that the Holy Spirit will roll out its alternative. So far, you know, it's right on track, very, very accurate. So I have every reason to be confident as we go forward here. Every reason to remain confident and even start to generate some gratitude here as I get over this, try to get over the shock of all these indications here that it's go time. Every indication, let's get some gratitude going because and I don't know what is going to roll out. You know, it will come bit by bit. We'll realize it bit by bit by bit. You know, say, oh, this is nice. Oh, this is nice. And I keep getting these delicacies being brought here of just, oh, more and more and more, like the finest sweets in the world and delicacies. It's amazing what's happening. free. Oh my gosh. I told you about all the meat, was all this fish and meat was developed, was delivered free. And now we're getting all these cakes and pastries and delicacies being delivered free. And yeah, I can't explain it. I had to be careful. I sampled about 8 different things last night, and I got sick from it. So, oh, this tastes great. Oh, this tastes wonderful. This tastes great. So, maybe that's just a sign, like, here come the delicacies. You know, here come the really sweet, wonderful stuff for those who have prepared properly. You know, it's not a shock. We say, oh, okay, we know this is going to happen, and there's just business as usual, really, in waking up from the dream. And we realize that this is, you know, there comes a time when something big is, you know, wonderful is necessary. We need to meet up with success. So it's time to meet up with success. You know, it's time to meet up with success. This is what needs to be emphasized for us now. We're turning the page. Okay, you know, the bad news. Okay, yeah, okay. We realize this is it. And yet now it is our time to meet up with success. Okay, real success. What is ultimate success? Ultimately, it's realizing that there's no such thing as any concretization. It doesn't exist. No such thing as bodies. No such thing as worlds. It's all a dream. And there's no such thing as any outcomes. All outcomes are just dreaming. And we can realize this. Absolutely, we can realize it. There have been some in this world who have realized this perfectly. So we can realize that for sure. And I say in this world, of course, as a manner of speech, that really for them, they realize there is no world. But from our standpoint, we would say in this world, where are we at now? So it's possible. I know it can happen. This is the goal. This is where we're going towards. This is the meeting up of success will take us there, like a train that takes us to this ultimately destination of no destination, no outcome, realization of that. So we're trying to turn the page. I'm trying to turn my mind and getting in a very positive framework, you know, for Monday, the blood moon, the Monday night will kick off. I believe it'll kick off. It kicks off the marketing campaign for the New World Agenda 21, and it may kick off the Holy Spirit's marketing campaign and alternative campaign. They may both start then. It's very possible. Very possible. And reading the tea leaves about public sentiment about this agenda, I mean, there's a lot of people, older people, who are not into it at all, okay? But it's the younger people, the tech people, because it'll create a massive, massive windfall, economic windfall for the technology sector in this world. And they've been getting the money. They were funded. Actually, they've been funded by black ops money that really was designed for this Agenda 21, actually. And it's been going on for quite some time, this agenda, working towards it. These technology companies were given seed money and helped out because they knew they needed this technology for Agenda 21. So they've been subsidized. It's a very sleazy behind the scenes situation, really, the whole technological thing, the connection between government and intelligent communities and spying communities and all this stuff, and these tech companies, you know, they're in bed together from the very beginning, and they're going to make ungodly profits, and this is why they're so in on it, because everybody's going to be monitored. And I know people working on monitoring software like crazy. They're metering everything, right? They're learning how to put smart metering everywhere. Everybody's going to be monitored. It is the greatest financial economic windfall in history that the tech companies, tech sector is going to get from Agenda 21. So they're totally behind it. And Google on its search page said, you know, hey, the sustainable goals, this is it. This is super important. Get into it. So they're heavily involved in promoting this, of course, because they're going to make, the greatest profits, more profits than anyone can ever imagine, along with the full tech sector. And so the tech sector is totally behind this. And they have the money. They have the means to persuade people. And they have the means to cleverly, deceitfully pressure, move people in through all the social media and everything that involves technology to get people into this. And the younger people growing up on all this tech stuff, they're in on it too. You know, they're heavily into it. But the older people, wiser people with more experience and realizing, hey, this really means the loss of sovereignty, not national, but personal sovereignty. This means a global police state. This means a global dictatorship. This is a dystopian nightmare. And it certainly does mean that. Probably worse than we know. So these older people are saying, hey, not so fast here. But they won't be listened to at all. They just seem to be, you know, like these older idiot people, the sooner they're gone, the better. Which is, I found the attitude of younger people, many of them towards older people, to say, you know, you uselessly screwed everything up, useless, you know, eaters, and the sooner you're gone, the better. Like, you know, just get off this world. Well, we might get off this world, but on our own terms, that's for sure. That is for sure. If we leave this world, it's on our own terms, and it's due to the Holy Spirit's agenda, and not anything that the tech people have any say in it at all. That is not to say that the older generations aren't without some culpability and blame in all this situation, but it was really the Green Revolution, which is a very much tied in with global corporations to manufacture more people, to manufacture a problem, so that the solution that they had in mind would fit the problem. There'd be a problem to fit the solution they had. See, they knew ahead of time what the solution they wanted for this world. And they said, well, we can't. How can we get the world to go along with this? I mean, you know, there's population is not that much, it's not that big. There's not such a terrible problem. We have to make a severe problem here in order to fit our solution. So they invested in this Green Revolution of trying to increase the population and destruction of natural resources and ecosystems, so that they could say, oh, guess what? You know, you guys really need this Agenda 21 that we have for you. Aren't you lucky that we have this for you? This is what happened. So you can hardly blame just the average person in the world. It's the Illuminati. It's the global corporate elite. It's all of this cabal that is heavily involved in this, along with extraterrestrials too. And they produced a problem to fit their solution, is what they did. So it's easy to scapegoat, you know, my generation, right? We're being made scapegoats, but we're not going to accept that. We're saying, no way, you're going to scapegoat us. So we're going to dodge this, sidestep it. That's what the Holy Spirit has assured me. There's a way to sidestep it. Pretty interesting stuff here, huh? A lot of wow factor. Now, I found the wow got so severe, I got a little bit ill. But not too bad. I wasn't throwing up or anything. I felt a little queasy and just said, wow, this is shock, going into shock here a little bit. But so, you know, just calming down a little bit, still feeling a little bit queasy, but not so bad. Just able to eat. So, you know, everybody should pat themselves on the back and realize that they were right, you know? They were right. And don't feel bad, feel elated, you know, feel, wow. Holy Spirit's going to roll out an alternative for this. This is what I've been saying all along. Holy Spirit's going to roll out an alternative for us here. I didn't see Agenda 21 as their one of their goals, saying we should invite back all the liberated spirits who have been liberated back to truth, you know, and drop pretense and falsity. Who have been liberated from the false belief in outcomes. Why don't we invite them all back to this quote-unquote world to help us out, to help us with religious education, to be truly oriented in the right direction? I don't see that goal there. Why didn't they do that? Oh, I guess that wouldn't make tech profits for all the tech companies, would it? Gee, it's about money. Who would have thought that? It's about money. I'm shocked to see it's about money. Gambling in Casablanca, that's not possible. Are you kidding me? So, it's about money, but ultimately it's about believing in fixation, believing in outcomes. Money's an outcome. You see, if we had the right religious instruction, spiritual instruction, there wouldn't be any need for this draconian dictatorship, global dictatorship, New World Agenda. There wouldn't be any need for any of this technology and all the profits they're seeking. There wouldn't be any need for any of that. So they manufactured this problem so they could make obscene profits. Kind of like the weapons manufacturers manufacture wars to make obscene profits on weapons. Only they're going to make a lot more profits on technology. So, I know some people get irritated, but I don't because I know the Holy Spirit's going to roll out its option for us, which is fabulous. Fabulous, fabulous, fabulous. We don't have to go along with this. There's an option. We have option. We have options. So the tech companies just see us as a way to just, you know, earn absolutely obscene profits for themselves and become the global elite, you know, total global elite. Just being used, you know, as people have begun to wake up to that and realize, wow. But we're not going to be used. We have someone smarter than the tech people, which is the Holy Spirit. Way smarter. Call it, you know, the super company. The super tech company. We work for the super tech company. We're part of that wonderful company and family, the Holy Spirit. Super tech. Beyond all other technology is the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit tech. It knows everything. It knows everything that's going to happen in the future. It knows every detail from the beginning. So, how about that tech? I'm going with that technology. Actually, that's the highest technology. It makes the other stuff look like it's completely in shambles. So, I mean, it's kind of stupid to go with, like, dysfunctional technology, isn't it? And that's what the world is doing. If you want functional technology, go with the Holy Spirit. If you want truly functional technology, go with the Holy Spirit. Anything other than that would be uncivilized. Absolutely. It would be uncivil society. It would most certainly. The UN loves the word term civil society. Civil, well, I would say using totally screwed up technology is not a good idea for civil society, whereas the Holy Spirit is the perfect technology to use for civil society, as well as governance, as well as every last person, last spirit, every last spirit there is. So we get a very exciting time now for us, because we get to be clued into the Holy Spirit and what it's going to do. We get to be clued into that, whereas the others are going to be staring into the dark tunnel of Agenda 21. I mean, you know, it's like going in a dark tunnel and having this little laser, little light, and you think, oh, how wonderful this is, how groovy this is. I mean, this is just the greatest thing. I'm in this terrible dark tunnel. I can see a little bit of light there. Oh, this technology is so fabulous. I love you, technology. Well, in order to make this technology they have seem fabulous, they have to put you into a dark tunnel first. So that's what they're doing. So, yeah, if you go into a severely dark tunnel, you might think the technology is kind of cool. But if you didn't go in that dark tunnel, you'd realize how ridiculous it is to think that way. The Holy Spirit has the real technology that we need, that we really want. The Holy Spirit has a technology we really want. Look at it that way. And it really does. So we're looking forward to that technology rolling out here. What's that technology going to be like? Makes this stuff we have now look like the Stone Age. And like I say, it is the Stone Age. It's a gilded Stone Age that the world is going into. A gilded Stone Age. Totally not being ignorant of the perfect technology the Holy Spirit has for us. You know, wow. What a pity. You know, what a pity. But they'll catch on at some point. Hopefully, you know, they'll catch on eventually to this. So it's a great day. Today's a great day. And we're going to start being clued in here. I don't know if I can sleep tonight. Questionable. This is really, you know, it's a lot happened at one time, just a burst here. It all sort of came to light suddenly, you know, like lightning lit it all up and said, oh my gosh. But it's a super positive. It's a super positive. It means we start to get, you know, glued into it now. We start experiencing, you know, the beginnings of it, of the Holy Spirit's option, agenda. You know, we get to begin to experience the beginnings of it now. So this is great. This is absolutely great for us. So don't worry about battling against Agenda 21 or whatever, you know, because we have an option. Let's start experiencing that option. You know, they're going to do, the tech people are going to do what they're going to do. Believe me, if you understand now, as you probably should and do, the profits for the tech sector and various other sectors that are involved in this Agenda 21, you realize there's no chance they're going to back away from this. No chance. This is their Valhalla. You know, this is their jackpot. They think they've hit the lotto. This is it. This is what they think. This is the outcome that they've been scheming for a long time, how to completely scam this world. And this is the outcome that, again, they have been blueprinting and following this, and it's right within their clutches now. So they're hardly going to repent at this time. You know, don't count on their repentance at this time. We pray for their repentance, but we're not, you know, going to wait on it. If they do it, wonderful. But, you know, you can see why they wouldn't do it. I mean, these companies are going to have devices, up the wazoo, everybody, everybody's going to have devices everywhere. There are going to be so many devices in the world monitoring everything that they can't even manufacture them fast enough. You're going to have most of the people of the world working just to manufacture these devices and distributing them. They're going to be put everywhere. That this is all in time. This is all in time. And the will to do it is there. 193 countries signed off on this Agenda 21 now. Getting ready for the Paris Climate Conference, which is going to, be the big push into 216. But these companies have already geared up and have already ready to produce, massive amount of monitoring equipment and software and coordination, and it's just colossal. It is a colossal global scheme involving untold trillions of dollars, actually. The profits are just going to be, we can't even hardly fathom them. So these top people who are going to profit from this, and I mean, they're just going to be so filthy rich, they think that this is their dream come true, And Jesus warned us about that, of putting profits before the spiritual path, right? Absolutely, we've been warned about that. So I always say it's a great blessing to be poor. It's a great blessing, have no status in this world, is you're not tempted. I mean, if we're up there, if we happen to be some, concho at one of these companies, the temptation, you're talking about being a multi-billionaire. A lot of these people realize they're going to be multi-billionaires. So many, some of them trillionaires. And the ego hit, it's just like, wow, I mean, just like, they can afford anything they want. And they just start dreaming about this and think, wow, I can be so happy because I can have such great status. I'd be so important. It goes to your head. It definitely does a number on you. And of course, there's also a whole massive flock of those who want to be, the spouses of these people or the significant others of these people, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Who just, managed to just get in on that alone. So they're frantically working to prepare to fit the image of these vastly wealthy people of what they want in companionship, knowing that this will bring them untold wealth, how mansions are all around the world, helicopter, plane flights, vacations, everything, you name it. The world will be their oyster entirely. So that there's this worldwide intense push by many people who see this opportunity coming up. There's going to be so much wealth going on. They're going to print so much money and produce so much money to be the companions of these of the wealth, This is how it works here. A lot, maybe paid companionship too. A lot are angling for that. These people will, drop $100,000 like it's nothing. So they're, this is, the camp followers of the armies in history. There's always been camp followers that they get to partake a lot of the spoils, The soldiers become wealthy of the looting and taking back all this treasure, and all these camp followers hook up with them, and they end up getting a lot of the loot themselves. Not having done any of the fighting at all. It's a pretty, cushy job for them if you can get it. But there's ferocious competition for that too. That's why all the plastic surgery, all the enhancements, beauty enhancements, ways of, it's just intense going on here. It's like a gold rush. It's the biggest gold rush in history is coming up here. This is what people realize, and I just realized it. This is what it's headed towards. Now, there may be, financial collapses and whatever, but it will quickly, they'll put it back together with the digital money or whatever, that they do it, And to control everybody. It's all about control at this point. And, the profit made and how to control people is the biggest gold rush in history. And people get gold fever. Now, like in California, we know about that. The 49ers that came over, the Gold Rush in 1849 rather. And they had gold fever all over the world. People just dropped their jobs and just get on a ship and just go. The idea of unlimited riches just drives people nuts. And then, of course, there were two groups of people that made a fortune off it, you know, besides the miners, maybe more than the miners, actually, were the suppliers. One perfect example, Levi Strauss made their fortune off of the miners, supplying the miners. Also happened up in Alaska and various places in the world that great fortunes are made supplying the gold fever, people with gold fever, and also the camp followers, you know, in various ways and dimensions, who, you know, hooked up with the gold miners and also the suppliers of the gold miners. So the money, you know, the whole thing was people were just, you know, like a mania. So when you get a gold rush, people get pulled into it severely, and you know it can affect anyone. It's like a plague. You know, many people haven't experienced that yet. We experienced the .com thing here in the Silicon Valley. It was like a mini gold rush, and I got caught up in it. You know, everyone was got caught up in it. You know, I lost my way. Actually, I really did. It's caused me severe troubles. I got into bad habits. It was a mania here. The .com thing was a mania here. People were just, you know, walking down the street. Well, you couldn't have an open container, but nobody really cared anyway. Maybe they just come in and buy these Dom Perignon like it was water. You know, they were taking baths in Dom Perignon champagne. They were just doing outrageous stuff with money. Money was just like flowing like water. And everyone felt they're going to be billionaires. Well, back then it was multimillionaires. Everyone thought, I'm going to be a millionaire, for sure. And so you get caught up in this. It was a mania. People from all over the world flocked in here. All dressing in the latest styles. Huge industries popping up to support this. All these industries popping up, service industries, you know, flower shops, you name it. Supplying these people who are just spending money like they had unlimited money. It was never going to end. Crazy, absolutely crazy. Well, with experience with getting caught up in this, I certainly don't want to go through another gold rush that makes this one look like nothing. Let the .com look like absolutely nothing. It's a global mania. And already the profits here in the Silicon Valley are absolutely obscene. But this is just the tip of the iceberg. Everybody, it seems here, is driving a brand new Maserati or, you know, high-end Audi, BMW, Range Rover, you know, whatever, Mercedes, whatever fancy car you can imagine. Everybody seems to be driving one. Like they're just filthy rich. It's all tech. It's all tech. Just the tip of the iceberg here. And this is now going to turn into a gold rush mania. And the danger is to get caught up in that. And I, looking back, I realized I did get caught up in it. And that's what led to extreme stress and troubles. Wow, I never saw that before, recognized that before. That I did get caught up in that. Hard not to. Everyone is giddy. Everyone becomes giddy. They think that the millennium has come. And everybody becomes seemingly friendly and open to one another. And, you know, it's like, hey, we're all rich. We're all rich. We're all going to be fabulously rich. And then when we're fabulously rich, we'll all be fabulously happy. So everyone starts getting giddy that we're finally going to be fabulously happy. And you think, wow, yeah, I want to be fabulously happy too. And I need to get in on this too. Wow. Holy cow, this is the danger then. This is the danger of getting swept up in this. What seems to be this incredible gold rush, but it'll end up very, very poorly indeed, it seems. Short term, you know, short term thing, giddy thing. You get hooked into waiting for outcomes then, and your whole structure becomes structured on it, and you've lost your spiritual way. And then the suffering comes, and it's horrible. Whew. Wow. Well, I certainly can be a strong advocate, because having gone through sort of pre-condition to avoid this, you know, having experienced this, you know, mini gold rush and living in the gold rush state, California, where we have long familiarity with this issue. Where everybody just, you know, San Francisco, just everybody was just party, 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 party. You kidding me? You know, the money's never going to run out. We've reached nirvana. Tech is globalized now. These tech companies are globalized. And you just saw what Volkswagen did in order to try and become dominant. They're willing to become fraudulent. Yeah, I mean, yeah, control is good for all the rest of you, but not for us. Profits are more important. Greed is more important. This shows you the greed showing up in Volkswagen like this is a, it should be a shocker to everybody. So keep in mind, this cold fever is liable to grip the planet, and millennial fever, that we're going into this time of unlimited potential and riches and happiness, as obscene profits are going to be made off of this vast global control system, measuring everything, making sure everyone, from every last person, every local area, every regional, every state, every country, every area in the world is being monitored and measured to make sure that it's on track, keeping up and not being left behind towards these 17 goals and all the sub-goals within them, the many, many sub-goals within them. So how about 169 in total, or 65 something, of all these sub-goals, they're going to us all under this regime. You know, I'm not interested in this regime. I'm not interested in it. You know, I'm a golfer. I'm used to playing my own golf ball. I don't have somebody else play my golf ball for me unless I ask them to. If it's the Holy Spirit, I say, go ahead. But, you know, we're not going to be part of this New World Agenda regime. This is only for some people want this. They think that, again, there's some righteous outcome that can come out of this. Again, truth is that there's no such thing as outcomes. So they're just going to be blinded to truth, very badly blinded. So, you know, enjoy the buzz of this video and the times we're writing now. Full stop in the wow, relax, and again, gratitude, because here comes the good stuff now. This is, we had to first see, do we really want to be part of this gold rush, and evaluate it, and we say no. Okay, then, now the Holy Spirit can lay out its option for us, and we'll say thank you very much. Otherwise, we might have felt it was trying to somehow obscure how wonderful the gold rush would be, trying to prevent us from seeing it. And we would have objected to that. But now they've already seen it, and the Holy Spirit hasn't laid out its agenda yet. I can say, well, thank you very much, Holy Spirit. I see it. I don't want it. I understand it now. Okay, I'm open to your agenda now. You didn't try to fool me or trick me or anything like that. Yeah, it's tough to wait this long for it, but I can see now that we might have had some resistance to it if we start thinking, hey, wait a minute. There's massive profits to be made, massive maybe good times and wealth and every happiness, and the Holy Spirit is laying out agenda to take me away from that. It might have caused severe conflict in us. So this is why we haven't had any particulars yet. But I suspect them, in my case, soon. Because I've been able to, now I can see and evaluate and say, wow, this is what's going on. Okay. Being living here in the Silicon Valley, somewhat of a benefit to you're tuned into the cutting edge more of what's going on in the world. But like I said, technology's been globalized. There's many global centers of technology now all over the world. And they're working on all sorts of stuff. Monitoring, connecting, making sure everybody stays on top of everybody else. Okay, what did you do today? If that was turned to spiritual path, that would be awesome in some ways, but it doesn't really work that way. And it's not attuned to it at all. So it's not a good development. You don't really need technology to take the spiritual path. You do not. It seems to thrive without it. So, this is big time. We are headed for the big time. What was else at 11? I noticed something. What did I notice? Escaped my mind, but... If it's not that important, so maybe that's why I have something more important to convey. Like the Herman's Hermit song says, something tells me I'm in for something good. Yeah, it's like, wow. Like in that accident that I told you about, that those two sort of well-bred people were shocked that they got pulled into this horrible situation. I could tell. They were full of remorse and regret. They were talking with me and they felt ashamed of it because they could realize I had some sort of authority and projected, competency and everything. And they were just like really shamefaced, like, wow, we really screwed up. Really screwed up. And this is the people of the world now. They think, oh yeah, well, it's not so bad. Those conspiracy people, they're nuts. We'll go along with this agenda and we'll see how it works out. And before you know it, they'll have got gold fever too and get pulled into it. And later on, they'll say, what did we do? What did we do? But, of course, there'll be someone there to help them out on the scene at some point, right? Like I was on the scene in the accident. Nobody else was doing anything. They didn't know what to do. I was in a can-do attitude, and at that time, I said, guys, has anyone called, for help? No, nobody. I said, well, we've got to do it right now. Let's take responsibility. Nobody wanted to take responsibility for anything, And so I sort of was put into that role there. It was pretty intense, jittery thing. Wow. So, yeah, at some point there'll be severe regret. The people who go down that path and think it's not going to be so much trouble. And then they'll need to be, you know, helped out. We'll help them out. Some people will be available, some teachers and whatever, to help them out and say, okay, look, time to repent. You know, you got to repent. And they'll probably do so. They'll probably do so at that point. They say, hey, we don't want to hang out with these, you know, these lowlifes anymore. I mean, these people who are so oriented towards death and suffering and outcomes. And, you know, it's time for us to, you know, say goodbye to that. Let's repent and get on the path. So many may repent out of this situation, you know, in the long term, looking at it in the short term, trouble, long term, it may result in a lot of repentance. So we need a lot of teachers to help them out. In the old terminology, we say a lot of therapists, you know, therapy. We need a lot of those who have repented and completed the path of repentance to help them out. We need to make it real here. We're talking about repentance. We're not talking about therapy. We're talking about repentance. We're talking about the spiritual path, which repentance is the spiritual path. It's a path of managing your success and repentance. So this is what they need help with, is repentance, the path of repentance. So I've certainly, having already done that, certainly have positioned myself to be, you know, helpful in some capacity at some point in the future, you know. Absolutely. So I'll just keep working on it and see how it goes. Hopefully I get a little promotion and, you know, and have whatever I've got developed further by those who are capable of developing it, you know, larger perspective, you know. And so I'm up for that, certainly game for that. So we can be, you know, more effectively helpful. It's very, very important. So this is this misadventure here. Hopefully it's short term, doesn't last too long. So let's not all get caught up in this immediate, you know, ain't it awful thing. You know, hopefully it's a short term problem. Some will, you know, go in the path of death strongly. Some will go in the path of violence and conflict strongly, and some will repent. Some will decide, you know what, time to repent. So maybe much good will come of it, you know, really. Maybe it's some sort of a shock treatment to get a lot of people a lot of us to repent. I believe that. I believe that's probably what it is. I really want to believe that. And it could very well be that way. I feel there's a lot of people who are just kind of lukewarm in the world. They want to repent, but they're still thinking, well, I'm going to kind of see what happens with all this technology. It's kind of interesting, not realizing the trap that's being laid for them. So at some point, you know, they'll say, oh, gosh, I really made a big mistake. I really got to get serious, and they're going to repent. There's a lot of very fine people in the world. They're just a little too lukewarm, okay? They just don't quite have the juice to be adamant right now. And so, but, you know, the shock treatment will wake them up in that regard, I would expect. And there's a lot in the world who don't really plan on repenting anytime soon, and they probably won't, which is okay. They have their timetable, too. It will come about for them maybe in a slightly longer-term situation. It's perfectly fine. Doesn't change their status and reality at all. So we are in it now. I mean, and it's no surprise, right? I mean, we've been experiencing the intensity of 215. And, of course, the Syrian thing is going to become, you know, this is super, super intense right now, right? And you can tell that there's trouble in River City. Okay, so, but, hey, for us, it's all great. It's all coming up roses for us. Coming up roses. All coming up roses for us. Why? Because we prepared. That's why. Those who prepare, comes up roses. Later on, they'll be able to help out others who repent along the path of repentance. That's what I'm all about. Helping out on the path of repentance is what has to be done. I understand the difficulty of it, and I wished I had more help. So for me, help is very important to have help. It's very helpful. The kind of, you know, the help I did get was just so supremely helpful. I just wish I had more of it. you know, I don't know why did not, but, you know, that just is what it is, and we'll have to see in hindsight why. You know, maybe it's tough love. It, you know, it makes you tougher if you really, you know, it makes you have to dig deeper and work harder and be more determined. So I might build in a lot of really, really, really helpful momentum that way possible. You know, they say if it doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger. Well, it almost did kill me. So, you know, but it has made me stronger. But it's pretty tough love, that's for sure. You know, steep path, quick path, steep path. So here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Not trying to anticipate what's going to happen exactly. Don't have any details. Just open to, you know, whatever happens, happens now for us. And we're just going to enjoy. It's all coming up roses. It's going to be fabulous. We're going to have a fabulous time here. And delicacies will just keep coming. I don't know what the next delicacy is, I'm telling you. Yeah, I'm not kidding you. We just have suddenly had people delivering a massive amount of delicacies here, unasked for, completely unasked for. I can't even eat them all. I mean, you know, I can't. I'm gonna start giving them away. Really, seriously. So, what's the next delicacy to be delivered here? I don't know. I really don't know. That's part of the excitement of it. You know, you don't know. You know there's going to be some kind of present under the tree soon, but you don't know what it will be. What is it? I don't know. Like I said, it might make it tough to sleep. But, you know, I may be giving it away like hotcakes, you know. Say, hey, this is too much for me. I can't go through. Come on, everybody. Get some of this, you know. Trying not to speculate, get pulled into speculation. The Holy Spirit, you know, trying to figure out what the Holy Spirit's going to do is kind of like a waste of time. It's better than expected, but it comes about in a way that is humorous, you know. You just say, come on, you know, how can you possibly know every last detail like this? It's just like, we have to laugh at it because it's so over the top, you know, it's just incredible. The Holy Spirit literally knows every last tiny detail of everything that's taking place, not only now, but to the end of our dream, too. And it's able to completely coordinate it all, and, you know, it's just ridiculous. But from its perspective, it's not it's not difficult. So it's just a different perspective. It's perfect, perfect certainty. So, okay, here we go. Here come the roses. Speaking of that, we were just given this massive bouquet of artificial flowers, but they look beautiful. Again, another deluxe freebie. Someone just gave us that. Wow. I said, what's that? A massive bouquet. Oh my gosh, that's beautiful. Wow. Just out of the blue. That's three. What's the fourth? Have to wait. And maybe till tomorrow. Great. Okay. So we're in on a high note here. You know, we're fired up. Fired up for what is to come. And we'll remain fired up and very positive now. Let's wash out all the negativity. It's enough's enough. We're looking forward to the delicacies to come. we're going to be treated better in royalty, you know, and we're just going to be blessed and blessed and blessed and blessed and blessed here. This is what's going to happen. So, you know, let the blessings begin. We're ready for it. All right. Very great, Holy Spirit. Thank you so much for all that you're about to do. That's it. Very great.